You enjoy it here in the nurseries?
Love it, always. Peaceful.
Peace and quiet. Right, okay. Quiet. You there? I'm with your mate here. He's here now, isn't he? Look.
Morning, Mark.
Morning.
Lovely day. Oh. Lovely.
Now it's our morning. What have you got here?
There you go. Say ta-ra, everybody.
Aye, thanks, and hopefully see you around sometime, somewhere.
And there you are. Happy wedding anniversary. Isn't that beautiful? How good is that? So we're starting off today's vlog from a very beautiful nurseries where it never rains. Well, it does sometimes on a Wednesday. And as you can see, I've got perfect blue sky. There was a bit of a chill in the air earlier, and we got some guests staying with us. And we've got a special day today. Right, what I'm going to do, introduce yourselves with your names.
I'm Adrian.
Hiya, Adrian.
Tina.
Gina.
Tina.
Tina and Tina. Now, you've been here a few times, haven't you?
Yes, a second time.
Right, and I've only just found out now that you're actually from Skeggy.
We are.
So, that's remarkable. Well, and obviously, you enjoy it here at the nurseries?
Love it, always. Peaceful.
Peace and quiet.
Right, okay.
Peace and quiet.
And today's a very special day, isn't it?
It is. Our anniversary, 38 years.
38 years. So I was just saying, I was just trying to think of an anniversary song, and then you just played me a song.
We did.
And I've never even heard of it. Who was it?
Slim Whitman.
What was the song called? The anniversary song.
Darling, happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary. So the only tune that comes to my mind at the moment is congratulations and celebrations. Will that do?
I can't sing,
but yeah, we could do a bit of altered images. Take instead of happy birthday, happy anniversary. Happy, yeah. No, that doesn't work, does it?
Blimey.
And yeah, but complete chill out. So your setup here is absolutely amazing. Look at that there, isn't it? Just yeah, absolutely beautiful, isn't it?
It's good enough for now. We'll change it next year. Get a new caravan next year.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
What are you gonna get? Do you know yet?
No, I was thinking we're back to a motorhome. I had a self build before, didn't we?
All right.
That blew up, so.
Oh God.
Big ends went on that. So we went to this old thing, didn't we?
Yeah, but it does us for now.
No, it doesn't matter.
We'll change it next year, get a newer one.
The daft thing with old cars and old caravan and anything old is at some point it will reach a stage where it becomes vintage.
Yeah, I'm getting there.
Yeah, it's a bit like us, isn't it? I think when you become an OAP, isn't it? I think that's when you're officially vintage. But some campsites won't allow old vans on and things like that, which is pretty mean, to be honest. But you can then get a caravan that's 50 years old, and they're absolutely beautiful.
Then it's retro, isn't it? Then you go retro, and then they'll allow that on.
Yeah, and it's the same with cars, isn't it? You know, if you get an old car now, I don't think they have to have MOTs over a certain age, and there's no road tax over a certain age.
Over 25 years, isn't
that's
it?
It.
You don't need road tax.
Yeah, it's a bit bit bizarre. But when do humans become retro?
Oh, you get bus pass. It's bus pass days, isn't it?
65, 66.
Yeah.
I keep putting it up, don't I?
Good grief. So I'm on a celebration date for a band called Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark today. So today is 45 years since they played a gig at a place in Liverpool called Eric's Club. And that's not going to mean anything at all to you, is it?
No.
So the only reason I threw that one in, it was a bit like that song you played to me before, because I didn't have a clue what it was. So I was just spotting the robins here that you've...
There was in the awning yesterday.
Did you?
I think it came into shelter from the rain.
Oh, good grief. Amazing. Very right, nice. I'm going to go and have a little wonder. I've got some, your neighbours are going. I'm going to go and say hello to them as well. So it's also saying goodbye to the people on pitch number 6 who've been with us for a wee while. They were packing up today. Yeah, at long last, the weather feels like it's October. Definitely a little bit chillier. Okie dokie, keep going. So I'm just doing a quick walk about, looking for any bits of litter. Mark, hello? Mark, are you there? I'm with your mate here. He's here now, isn't he? Look.
Morning, Mark.
Morning.
Lovely day, lovely.
Now it's our morning, but he may be watching the evening.
Oh, who gives a crap?
Yeah, that's true, isn't it? Right, how long have you been with us now? You've been with us a few days, haven't you?
Friday. I'm Sunday morning.
Losing track of days. Thursday today, isn't it? Almost a week. Wow.
Yeah.
That's gone fast.
Yeah.
So we had a bit of rain yesterday, didn't we?
Oh. Yeah, a lot.
No, a little bit. The water.
Yeah, it was a sprinkle. It was a sprinkle.
The water irrigation system, as we like to call it, wasn't
just
it?
Just dampen the grass, keep it green.
Yeah, I mean those aren't puddles there. They're mirages. Yeah. They're not puddles. And you've been with us a couple of times now, haven't you?
Yeah, popped up for the 40s weekend in Alford.
Yeah.
In July.
Yeah,
end of July.
And then you're with your friends next door, aren't you?
Gary and Karen. Yeah, they come up.
Yeah. And you were just saying, obviously, I've seen you going out every day, been out exploring the area.
Yeah,
I've
been checking out Lingatures. We don't often come up here. This is our second time caravanning up here.
Okay. And where are you from?
Basildon in Essex.
Oh, right. Oh, crikey.
Yeah.
Oh, blimey.
Good old Essex.
Yeah, Essex boys and Essex girls.
Yeah.
Marshy, Phil, he's from one of my friends, is from Essex. Where can I remember the name of the town now? I can't remember. And you've got a gorgeous doggy here, haven't you?
Yeah.
It's a bit of an old one, aren't we? Hey.
Little Gabby, 16 and blind now.
16, so I was just saying, we've had three or four dogs staying with us that are of the age of 16. The people that were, the Mat Lads people I call them, their dog was 16 as well.
We wander. We don't walk, we wander now.
Yeah.
You know. But no, she's enjoying it. The other one's asleep in the caravan. She's getting old as well.
A bit like Rasha. She wouldn't. Rasha got her out yesterday morning for a walk, and then yesterday afternoon when it was raining, she does. No. Wouldn't have any of it. So.
Yeah. So we'll pop out this morning, have a bit exploratory of the area.
Yeah.
Then a bit of chilling.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Tomorrow might be a complete day of doing nothing.
Fingers crossed. Well, I'm hoping.
I'm not doing much tomorrow because of the date.
What's the date?
It's Friday.
The 13th. Oh. Yeah. Right. Yeah. In that case, you know what? I'm going to take tomorrow off then.
Yeah.
Is it really? It will be in it Friday the 13th. Yeah, oh, God. So God, what?
I won't be doing much that day apart from minimal.
What could possibly go wrong? And thank you ever so much. You've bought us some gifts as well. So, for us. Yeah.
Beer.
So, Sandra, the bottles of beer, which are you'll see, this is the person, Dave, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is Dave and his other half, Lynn.
Hiding.
Yeah, she's hiding. who bought the beer. So, from Sandra, I'll do it. Hello, Dave. Thank you for the beers. That wasn't very good, was it?
No.
Failed.
Yeah, foul. Yeah. Almost as if she was here.
I'm not probably going to be getting anything out of the mower shed today, but I will open it up. I've got some bits coming from Amazon, actually. Another day at the nurseries. And we've got another regular visitor coming to stay with us this afternoon, who I'm sure we will be getting on camera. Now, can you guess who that's going to be? For those who've been watching the channel a bit will know. So I think he's up for four nights, and I think we've got something on this afternoon here for a week as well, another one. Okay, back into the office we go.
The scene is set for something that I'm doing later. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of things are in the hat. Who's going to be a lucky one and get one pulled out? Who knows? Right, that's toilets and showers done. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do for the rest of the afternoon. I've just got some arrivals to be seeing to. And the weather has gone very, very grey. It was bright and sunny earlier. And we seem to have got We seem to have got the grey sky back with us. Grey skies turn to blue. Grab myself a pie for my dinner. Hello, Rasha, how are you? You're a bit more lively here today. You having another bouncy? Not gravy bone. A couple of gravy bones. How's these? What have you got here? There you go. Right. Today, powered by pork pies. It was a little bit strange. We were talking to somebody a little bit earlier. Now, those of a certain age, when we had food, fresh food, there was no such thing as best before dates or use by dates. And same on things like milk. And a lot of people now just throw away food when it's still fine to eat. So did you used to, and in fact, do you still, when you get a pint of milk, do you still automatically sniff it like you did 40 or 50 years ago, just to make sure it hadn't gone sour? And bread, you used to just keep the bread going until it was either rock hard or a bit of greenery turned on it. And you just cut the green off. And cheese. If your cheese starts to go mouldy, oh, sorry, just cut it off. We'll carry on eating it. Yeah. Did it do us any harm? That is the question.
Right, welcome to the nurseries, pitch number 3. Even though you're on pitch number 31.
We've just described ourselves as a gaggle of wardens staying here. So there are 2, 4, 6 other wardens on the site staying at the moment, plus myself. We've got 7 wardens here, which is quite interesting. So what do you call a group of wardens? Are we a gaggle of wardens or a gaggle of geese?
Mark, it's a sad day, isn't it?
Yeah, not good.
You've been here since was it March?
March,
right. April, May, June, July, August, September. Was it 8, 9 months, something like that?
8 months, yeah.
And you're migrating away from the nurseries for the winter and onto other things.
Yeah, I'm not too sure what yet.
Right.
Few things on the go, but.
So a lot of people have sort of picked up, but they haven't seen you for a while, and obviously you've got your own little fan club out there. They're all missing you. Hey?
Yeah, it was a shame to go, but, you know.
Yeah, no, it's okay. Things happen. Sometimes it's time to move on and things. I was just going to say something then. So I know you are moving on, but what's your summer? Because obviously you've never done anything like this before. It's been a bit of a...
It's been good. All round good, really. Yeah.
It's been an eye-opener, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been good.
Seeing behind the scenes and some of the frustration we have and everything and all, you know, the site being quiet and then being busy.
Yeah, yes. Overall, everything good. Yeah.
No, it's a lovely site, and I just hope you've got lots of good memories, and you know you picked up quite a lot of experience, and not just the campsite, but obviously Mark's Cafe and the shops. Them did really well, didn't it? In the end, ice creams.
Magnums.
Was that definitely the best seller?
Probably kept us going, ticking over. I suppose.
Yeah, you could earn a wage off Magnums. But it wasn't that, even with the essential shop, you know, that like the tea towels ended up really regular, and bin bags and scourers and...
It's in other bits, shop-wise and whatever it is, so what you thought would do all right didn't.
No.
So pretty random.
Yeah. But they did well, and we're all going to be really, really sorry to see you go, and I'm sure our paths will cross at some stage.
Yeah, we'll pop back and see how you're all getting on at some point.
Yeah.
Sort of, who knows what the future holds.
The future will be silent. Sorry, I know a song like that by Orchestral Maneuvers in the Dark. Sorry, there's you could write a song there, isn't it? That's a good song title, isn't it? Who knows what the future will hold? You could write that. You could write a song called that, couldn't you? Well, I'm sure everybody out there, Mark, is going to really wish you best wishes and good luck for the future, wherever your road goes.
Thanks to everybody that's met on the campsite and that. And
Joe, don't forget, everybody's going to miss Joe as well, aren't they? Because obviously Joe's had his own, his people being Joe, dog treats and dog biscuits and everything, haven't they?
Yeah, I'm back for the last time.
Because I think that was a bit of an eye-opener for you, how many presents and gifts and people came to meet you, wasn't it?
Yeah, quite surprising, really.
And then you kept going, my dog's getting fat.
It's still a problem, it's an ongoing problem.
No, it's been, we've, at times, been like two grumpy old men, and, you know, but I think for the most part, we've been good company.
Been good, it's been good.
We've had some good chats and been to the pub a couple of times and everything, and be sorry to see you go, Mark, but I'm wishing Mark well for the future as well.
I was sort of sorry to go as well, but it's...
No, you know when your time's come, if there's time for change and everything, and, you know, as they say, it's the way the mop flops.
That's it, yeah.
All life's journey, one big adventure, isn't it?
That's the thing, you never know what the final destination is, do we?
I do.
Well, yeah, yeah.
The grave. Yeah, well, I'm not going in the grave, yeah, but no. Yeah, yeah, your final destination is,
yeah. Yeah, obviously, yeah. But those of a certain age, and like, that's the final destination. But
this time next year, fingers crossed, I'll be living in Lincolnshire. But I may not have sold my house, and who knows? It's
so it was looking good there for a bit, wasn't it?
But yeah, well, it's the way it goes. It's the way the cookie crumbles. Mark, go on, say give everybody a wave goodbye and say ta-ra, everybody.
Hi, thanks. Hopefully see you around sometime, somewhere.
Right. Hang on a minute. We need a going out song, and one's just come to my head, Mark, and you'll know this one. So those of a certain age, and I'm going to tell a story about this song I'm going to sing, and you'll join in with me. Lee, my youngest boy, when he must have been about 7 or 8, they had a theme at school about the Second World War. And Lee came home one day singing this song I'm going to sing now, thinking it was a new song. He didn't realise it was a war song. He had no idea. And that song is, Mark, you need to sing this. We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again on some sunny day.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
sort of about sums it up, really.
Yeah, we'll meet again, Mark. Don't know where, and I don't know when. But I'm sure we will.
Yep.
Thanks, Mark, ever so much. It's been brilliant. On behalf of the nurseries, you've been an asset to the site, and you've done really good. And I'll genuinely be sorry to see you go.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Thanks, Mark. Be-dump. You see, when you're a campsite warden, there are an array of other jobs you do. So, dinky dinky dink. Do you remember earlier on today? Right, I've spent a lot of money on this. It's cost me a flipping fortune. Well, as soon as I found out it was your wedding anniversary, I thought, you know what, I've got to go out and spend a fortune. I do believe that this is for you. And there you are, happy wedding anniversary, isn't that beautiful? How good is that?
Thank you.
Hey.
That's a nice change, don't you see? No expense spared.
Oh, love is in the air, everywhere I look around. You're welcome, love is in the air. Right, what a day. So, those who have been asking about Mark, yes, there's the news for you. And coming up soon, in the next couple of days, we'll give you an introduction to the new people that we've got coming on. They're actually on the site now, so look out for that. I'm going to wrap this video off here, and wishing you all well. Stay tuned in, and all being well, we'll get another vlog from the campsite warden to a screen near you very soon.